In this video, I'm going to explain why color filters can be really useful in black and white photography. Hi guys, my name is Matti Sulanto. I'm a photographer and a Lumix ambassador. And in this video, I'm going to explain why color filters can be extremely useful in black and white photography. And in this video, I'm only going to talk about digital black and white photography because that's what most people are doing. I'm going to explain why you might want to use a color filter for your digital pictures. And I'm also going to explain the difference between a digital filter and an analog filter. And then I'm going to compare a digital filter and an analog filter. And that's going to be interesting because this old-fashioned analog filter has some distinct benefits compared to a digital filter. But let's get started and let me first explain why you might want to use a color filter for your black and white photos. When you are taking a black and white picture or you are converting your color picture to black and white, you are essentially assigning a grayscale value to each color in the scene. And it can be possible, even likely, that two very different colors can have almost the same grayscale value. And therefore, it can be almost impossible to separate those two colors or tell them apart in the picture because in grayscale, they look the same. Let me show you an example so you can understand better. Here's an awesome picture of a traffic sign that I shot the other day. And as you can see, there's a red and blue on the traffic sign. But now, when I convert this picture to black and white or monochrome, you can see that all of a sudden, the red and blue on the traffic sign, they look almost identical. It's almost impossible to tell them apart. But now let me apply a red filter to this picture, and all of a sudden, the red part of the traffic sign is very bright, and the blue part of the traffic sign is even darker. So as you can see, the red color filter makes a big difference in this particular picture. And you probably noticed in the previous example that when I applied a red filter, the red color looked lighter and the blue color looked darker. So whenever you apply a color filter to a black and white picture, it always makes the filter color look lighter and the opposite color look darker. So if you apply a red filter, it makes color red appear lighter and color blue or green appear darker. And now let me explain what is a digital filter and an analog filter like this one here. A digital filter essentially manipulates the color information in the picture. And you can apply a digital filter either in camera if you shoot black and white or in post when you are processing your pictures. However, it's important to realize that if you shoot black and white JPEGs, you can't apply any color filters to those in post because the picture is already in grayscale and it does not have any color information anymore. But if you shoot color JPEGs or color RAW, or RAW is always color, of course, if you shoot color JPEGs or RAW, then you can convert those pictures in black and white in post and still apply color filters to those pictures as well because all the color information is still there even though the picture looks black and white. It's essentially like a desaturated color picture. Let's have a look at another picture here and you'll understand better what I'm trying to explain. Here's a gorgeous still life with a bell pepper and two apples. And first I'm gonna convert it to Adobe Monochrome in Lightroom, which is essentially a black and white picture, and it looks like this. And now I'm gonna go to the black and white panel here, and I'm gonna move the red slider back and forth, and as you can see, the red colors in the picture become brighter or darker depending on where I put the slider. So I'm essentially applying a color filter here to this black and white picture. And Lightroom also has black and white or monochrome color profiles, camera profiles that simulate certain color filters like red, blue, green, or yellow. And if you use one of these camera profiles, you don't have to manually fine-tune the sliders if you don't want to. But there's one more thing to realize, that if you use any of the camera matching monochrome camera profiles in Lightroom, you can't use any of the color sliders or color filters to that picture. You have to use Adobe Monochrome color profile or one of the other Adobe Monochrome profiles in order to use the color sliders to tweak the grayscale values in the picture. And Lumix in-camera color filters are similar to Lightroom color filters. Not identical, but similar. So if you are a JPEG shooter, I encourage you to experiment with your own camera and see which filter you like the best. And I have a previous video, which is up here, where I experiment with some Lumix black and white settings. You may want to check it out if you are interested in black and white photography. So these digital filters are quite handy because you can use them in post and use them with any picture, and you can fine-tune the filter in post. However, sometimes a digital filter can look pretty ugly. Let me show you one example. Here's an awesome landscape picture I shot the other day. There's this tree against a blue sky. And let's apply a red digital red filter to this picture. And let's zoom in. And as you can see, those tree branches look very artificial. It looks like somebody took a pencil or some sort of brush and manually painted those tree branches. It looks pretty ugly, to me at least. But now let's take a look at another picture of the same scene that I shot through this old-fashioned analog red filter. And the picture is here, and when we zoom in, we can see that the tree branches and the whole scene looks very, very natural and pleasing to the eye. And there are no signs of any kind of artifacts, and the whole scene looks very pretty and natural. So even though a digital filter can be really, really handy, sometimes it can render pretty ugly results as we just saw. And especially in landscape photography with lots of blue sky, sometimes an analog filter like this can render much more pleasing results. And that is because a digital filter essentially manipulates certain color or colors in the scene. And sometimes the transition from a color to another or grayscale to another can be really harsh, as we saw in the example that I showed you. But if you put this on your lens, all the light that hits the sensor must go through this red filter or any color, whatever you have on your lens. So everything that hits the sensor has already gone through this color, and that makes the transition between different colors and shades of gray much more pleasing and natural. But when we look at the practicality of a digital and analog filter, then the digital filter wins hands down because you don't have to carry anything extra with you, and you can apply the filter in post and fine-tune the filter in post. However, if you shoot a lot of landscapes, I strongly suggest you, black and white landscapes that is, I strongly suggest you experiment with those digital filters and see how they behave, and sometimes you may find that putting an old-fashioned analog filter on your lens probably renders much, much more pleasing result. I like black and white photography, and I have played around with those black and white presets and filters in Lightroom quite a lot. And I have learned that, at least in Lightroom, the yellow and orange filter work the best for landscape photography or any photography with lots of blue sky. Then I can't see any of those artifacts that I showed you earlier with the red filter. And I have also learned that these old-fashioned analog filters still have a place even in digital black and white photography. And if you shoot a lot of landscapes, a red filter like this or some other color filter can be useful and it can render better results than a digital filter. And please let me know if I missed something important in this video regarding black and white digital photography. And also share your experiences if you have used color filters in digital black and white photography. Leave a comment down below. I hope this black and white color filter tutorial was useful, and I thank you for watching. And here's another black and white topic that I have done before. Please take a look if you're interested. Thank you, and I'll see you in the next video.